Hello kids, so today we are going to learn the new block 10th one. So in this 10th block, what is our aim today? So today our aim is to identify the theme of the poem. Theme means what the poem wants to tell to us. So what is the author wants to tell to us? So basing on that, our poem is this. So what is the poem? The poem is leisure. What is the meaning of leisure? Leisure means free time. So what do we do regularly in our free time? Normally do we have the free time? Basing on this, we can have our class. So let us go through the poem leisure. Okay.
Leisure. Now let us see leisure poem. Can you see the scenery there? So it is a poem, according to the genre, it is a poem written by William Henry Davies. So can you see a squirrel on the tree, the moon, the trees? It's too dark. Can you see there? It's very dark. So according to the author's perspective, which means that according to his seeing, means what he is seeing, according to what he is able to guess. So if you see and observe something, everyone will have their own opinion. So in the same way, what is author's opinion? Basing on his opinions, he has written this poem leisure. So let us read this poem leisure. What is this life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. So coming to the first two stanzas, what is this life if? So if there is full of care, means every time someone is caring, someone takes more care of our life. So why? They are caring that much. So we don't have time. So no time. We have no time to stand and stare. Means even to stand to in a place and to look at something. So we are not even getting some time, some free time, the leisure time. We are not getting to stand at one place and to stare. So according to others' perspective, what do you think we want to stand and stare? What do we want to stand and look at? He wants us to stand and stare at the nature, because we can see, according to him, nature is the best thing. He gave a picture of nature there. Yes, so by that we can guess maybe he's talking about the nature, because even in the second stanza he gave that no time to stand beneath the boughs. What do you mean by the boughs? The branches of the trees. Nowadays we are unable to find the trees. So how come we stand under the trees? Beneath means under. So how come we stand under the trees and how come we look at? So he wants us to stay, to look continuously and stare as long as sheep or cows. See, if you see the sheep and the cows, they can stand somewhere, they can look at the nature, they don't have anyone to care about them, but they will be moving here and there, they will be spending their time. Most of the time the sheep and the cow, they stare at the nature and they will stand near the boughs. They enjoy the nature. Okay, now let us see the next one. No time to see when woods we pass, where squirrels hide their nuts in grass. Now, did you ever pass the woods? Do you know what are the woods? Woods are nothing but the forest. Did you ever go to a forest, children? So normally when we go into a forest, we spend very less time. But here, the author wants us to observe the squirrels. So do you know what the squirrels do? They eat the fruits and they hide their nuts in the grass. And because of this only, normally the plants are growing. Because the squirrels are hiding their nuts in the grass, they grow into plants. So actually in forest, why the squirrels are hiding their nuts, they don't know. But author wants us to stand and to observe how the squirrels are hiding their nuts. Now, no time to see in broad daylight, streams full of stars like skies at night. So when there is broad daylight, means no need of using the lights like power, electricity and anything, but we can see maybe in the night because of the moonlight, maybe in the daytime because of the sun, naturally we have light. So in that broad daylight, whatever it might be, the streams full of stars. Do you know what are streams? the rivers that are flowing, the water bodies that are flowing, we call them as the streams. Streams means water bodies, the river. So river full of stars. What do you mean by river full of stars? Do you know, in the night time when we look into the river, we can see all the stars, the mirror image of the stars in the water. That means the streams are having full of stars, like skies at night. So at night, what we see at night, how we can see the stars in the sky, in the same way, even we can see the stars in the night time in the rivers. Not even the stars, but early in the daytime also, if the sun rays falls on the river, at that time also we can see some shining in the water. So then also we can say the streams are full of stars. They are giving some light back, the shining which they can get from the sun. So such things, these are the things which we can see in the nature. Children, did you ever enjoy like that? Did you ever see such things in the nature? So what the author wants us to see, why he wants us to see all this? Really, it will be very fun to look like this. It's to enjoy the nature. No time to turn at beauty's glance and watch her feet, how they can dance. See, he is telling the nature as beauty and he is asking us to watch her feet and how it is dancing. So this is called personification. See, if something which cannot do, a nature is a thing, it is not a human being, but it is giving, the poet is giving a human nature to the to a thing. So can really the nature can dance? Nature, can we say it's beauty? Can we watch her feet? No. But still the author wants to say in this way because he is personifying the poem. That means he is explaining the poem in his own way by comparing it with the beauty of a girl or maybe the beauty of something. So he is explaining it by giving it a life. So thinking it as a beauty and watch her feet when it dance. So he wants us to enjoy just by seeing the beautiness which is there in the nature. No time to wait till her mouth can enrich that smile her eyes began. So here the natural beauty scattered around. So the beauty which is there in the nature, it is dancing like a girl, and the smiling face, we are not able to see its smiling face. So he asks us to refresh ourselves by observing carefully the nature. So as human beings, he wants us to spend some time with the nature, to look at the beauty of the nature which is spread around us, and he wants to enjoy our life. So he's saying a poor life this is full of care, we have no time to stand and stay. Why he is calling that our life is poor life? Because as a machines, we are working from morning till evening without any leisure time. Though we get some leisure time, we are not enjoying it. We are not trying to spend time with it. So that's why author wants to tell that our life is a poor life. We are not able to enjoy. Now, what is the theme of this story? In this story, the poet is telling that we are working too hard and being burdened with a lot of worries, and he wants us to get the benefit of relaxing and appreciating the nature, by which we can enjoy a lot and we can get relaxation from the nature. So now let us see the summary of this poem. Children, now you can take a screenshot of this summary so that you can go through this story, and whatever I explained, it will be there in that, and you can observe that what really the poet wants to know us. So about the nature, he wants us totally to stay in the nature, to enjoy the nature, to play with the nature, the beautiness, whatever is there in the nature. So he wants us to relax by seeing the nature. So basing on that, we can write our volume. Now, if you see your page number 10, S1, leisure. So, take the sentence that describe the poem leisure. Now, read three options are there. You read the three options carefully and tick the correct one. Now, coming to second one, write the lines from the poem that mean that we don't have time to look at the rivers which look like the sky at night. So what lines are there from that? The two lines, whatever are there, you can write just by seeing from the textbook. Now, third one, explain the meaning of these lines in your own words. So, can you see the two words there? Two sentences. So, you try to explain those two sentences which were given there. Now, coming to fourth question, what message does the poem Leisure give us? So, basing on the context given, what did you understand about the leisure and what message is the poem giving us? So, basing on that, you want to complete the fourth question. Now, complete it and send through WhatsApp.